What's up, guys? My name is Chioma. I'm here with Kose, and we're doing Ask the Players.
Boom.
So the first question we have for Kose is, how are you doing with your Spanish language?
I think it goes pretty well. I mean, we're learning a lot, and when I came here to Spain, I didn't know one word. And so I feel like now I can understand, I can communicate with my teammates, and I think I'm on the right way, even though we have like a break now since it's been the quarantine, so I can't wait to start with the lessons again.
Yeah, I agree. I think for her, she understands a lot. For me, I had Spanish classes in school for a little bit. Yo escrito y yo leo más o menos muy bien, pero yo escucho y yo habla es muy malo en mi opinión.
No, you understand a lot.
In my opinion.
You're hard to yourself, but you understand a lot.
Okay, the next question we have is, what is your most memorable moment as a player?
My most memorable moment as a player, it's hard to choose.
Yeah.
Obviously the Olympic silver in Rio with the national team.
Yeah.
Taking bronze with the national team this World Cup. Playing Champions League final. It's hard to choose. Yeah. I have a lot of really good memories that I will carry on my whole
life. Sure. Yeah, for sure. I mean, you've had a great career and it's only hopefully keep going up. For me, it was probably on my birthday, I got my first call up to the national team, and then in my first camp, I got my first cap, and then I got my first goal. So that whole like 2 weeks was super special, kind of like what dreams are made of, you know?
Yeah, and you have the future ahead of you. You're still young.
So next question some of you guys asked is, who's the funniest on the team?
It's hard to choose, except us too. I think Dai is very funny.
No, I agree. I think we all have like a different kind of humor.
Yeah.
So it just depends on the day. But if I had to pick one, I would go with Dai too, because she's just always pulling pranks and, and tricking people, and it's a good time.
Yeah, for sure.
Another question you guys asked is, what does it feel like to be the first woman to play for Real Madrid?
For me, it's a huge honor and responsibility to wear this club's crest, and I will. It was an emotional moment to sign for the club. Yeah. Obviously, it's the biggest club in the world, and this club is about winning, and that is what we want to do. It's the only option, I would say.
Yeah. No, I agree. Everything she said, I completely agree. I think, like she said, it's the biggest club in the world. The success this club's had is amazing. When we did the tour, you really get a feel of how great this club is and how they just keep pushing to the next level. So to be a part of that from the very beginning is incredible, and the badge is muy bonita, you know? So I'm just really excited to see what we do this year.
Yeah, and it's a new chapter for the club. I mean, it's gonna light a lot of dreams for all the young girls that are dreaming to play for Real Madrid, as I did when I was a kid. So now we have some questions from our fans to you, Chioma. And one of the questions is, which one of your feet is the strongest?
All right, so one, I like that question because that means I somehow look maybe even, which is not the case, but I'm very much left-footed. The right one's probably just there for standing, but I'm trying to work on it every day. But I'm left-footed, left-handed.
Good answer. if you could choose a hat trick or a last minute winner?
Oof, that's a tough one.
Are you even thinking about that?
I think you know, both are great, but I think the feeling you get when you score like a late goal to help the team win is pretty unmatched, so I would go with the match winner.
For sure, 100%. No feeling is better than to score a last minute winner.
Yeah.
Now I'm answering your questions. okay, another question for Chioma is, what is your daily routine?
For training or like games?
Yeah, I would say like coming to training and after. What do you do after training?
Okay, so I'm a big morning person, so I get up probably around 6. I like to just kind of get my body awake. I drink water like right when I wake up. Do the whole, you know, brush your teeth, wash your face, whatever. Make breakfast. I usually have an omelet with some fruit, some bread, and some orange juice. And then, you know, I get ready to leave, and I listen to a podcast when I'm traveling to training. Usually listen to Oprah. Oprah has some good podcasts
Good choice.
that I really enjoy. But yeah, that's pretty much it for me.
Do you feel ready for the level of commitment to play for Real Madrid?
Yeah, absolutely. I think where I'm at in my career right now, I think I'm on 6 year playing professionally, and all my experiences so far have helped me a lot, and I'm just ready to represent what this club, you know, stands for. And I think with pressure, you see a lot of what kind of person you are, and with the great teammates I have and then playing the World Cups, Olympics, we just have a great team that's only going to challenge everyone to be better and bring the best out of everyone. So for me, I'm super excited, I'm super ready. And, you know, I think we all have high expectations for ourselves. And,
sure.
You know, these are just all words. I'm just really excited for the games to start so we actually show, you know, show what we're about, for sure.
What's the hardest part of the training? I would say the preseason or...
Okay.
Hardest what part do you like? What don't you like?
Okay. So for me, I enjoy training. I like you do as well. And I don't know why, but the warm-up for me is like, I wish you could kind of like snap your fingers and your body's ready to go and then you can start training. But for me, it's just always hard to kind of get the body going because you're just really eager to get into the training.
Yeah.
But obviously warming up, stretching is very important. But I would say that's the hardest part for me.
Here's another one. What do you do during your free time when you're at home and not training?
So I'm a bit of a nerd, so I just recently learned how to code. I took a class in
which
quarantine.
I think is so impressive.
Thank you.
I just want to say that.
Thank you. So I just kind of wanted to learn about programming, computer programming, and since we had a lot of time off, I took a class and recently passed, so I'm a certified programmer, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
So just been doing that on my computer, learning and trying to make applications.
Yeah. She'll do my next app. Got my...
Kosovare.com.
Yeah. Last questions for you is, do you identify you as American, Nigerian, or English?
Nice. So for me, I think all of them is who I am. I grew up with Nigerian parents and was raised in a Nigerian household. A lot of things we did impacted my Nigerian culture. I eat a ton of Nigerian food, I go to a lot of Nigerian parties, I wear a lot of, you know, Nigerian clothing. So for me, that's a big part of me, and I was born in London, and I think my English part of me is like why I love football so much, and now it's, you know, my career, so that's a big part of me. And then I grew up in America, I moved there when I was three, so I think all of them play such a special part in me, and it's hard to choose one. I think it's just all three. All right, now we're gonna switch and we're gonna ask some of the questions you guys asked to Kosa. So one question you guys asked is, how many languages do you speak?
How many languages? I speak Swedish, English, Albanian. I lived almost 4 years playing for PSG in Paris, so I'm pretty okay in French. And
she can speak French.
And learning Spanish now.
Nice. I can speak English.
Yeah. And Spanish.
Another question for Kosei is, what is your earliest memory of playing football?
My earliest memory playing football was playing with my older brothers.
Nice.
And competing with them.
Yeah.
I made it. It was all about winning from start, even competing to my brothers. So I remember like just juggling around with the ball, and they would go to the pitch and try to get rid of me because I was too young. You don't want to have your sister with me, with them. So, but I knew where the pitch was. So I always ended up there and competed against them, even cheated to win, you know.
You ain't cheating, you ain't trying.
When it comes to juggling. So that is my first memory.
Nice. I feel like not everyone, but a lot of girls who got into football was because they had older brothers. Like for me, it was the same thing. I have two older brothers, so it was like trying to copy what they were doing.
I think normally they're role models from start.
Definitely.
And you want to be like them.
Yeah.
And you want to play football. Although I ended up supporting the best team in the world.
All right, another question we have is, what's the biggest difference you feel to live in Spain and then versus living in Sweden?
I would say the weather. For sure. The food is amazing, the way people live their lives, I think it's amazing. I've said it before, that's a small thing, but I really appreciate seeing it.
Yeah, no, I agree. I think Spain has a really easy, fun way of life, and I think the people here are really nice. So it's been super easy to come in and just get adjusted, you know?
Yeah, I think it's the first country or the first city where I felt the most at home.
That's
I lived in, even though I played in Sweden. So.
Okay, bien. Another question you guys asked for Kose is, who is your favorite Real Madrid men's player?
When I grew up, it was obviously the Brazilian Ronaldo. He was my biggest role model growing up. But then again, we know like Real Madrid has so many legends that played for the club. Di Stefano is one of them. Zidane is another one. They have a lot of great players that played for the club historically wise. So, Brazilian Ronaldo was my favorite.
Nice.
What's yours?
It's hard to pick, right? Like you just named legends, and that doesn't even touch like all the players that played for Real Madrid.
Yeah.
I think for me, being born in London, you know, I love David Beckham. Another question for Kose is, what is your diet?
My diet. I eat a lot of vegetarian food.
Nice.
I really, when I cook at home, it's either vegetarian or fish. So I would say that is my daily diet. Although I eat sometimes meat, but it's not like my favorite. I prefer vegetarian or fish.
Cool.
It's a little bit Scandinavian. A lot of fish, potatoes.
No, fish is great though.
And pasta. Yeah. I love to cook pasta too.
Yeah. Nice.
So I have a little bit of everything.
Yeah.
And I enjoy cooking. Do you?
Yes, I love cooking. I kind of eat like the same thing a lot. Like I don't mind repeating, but I make a lot of Nigerian food. So, which is cool because here in Spain, I've actually found a lot of stores that have African spices, which surprised me, but definitely cool.
Great.
2, 3. A la Madrid!